What's up, y'all? I've gotten a lot of questions lately after a few videos I've recently dropped about my GoPro setup, specifically the GoPro setup over the shoulder and how I power it all day. So we're gonna go over that right now. Now I know the Session is an older model GoPro, but there's a reason I choose that over the newer models. It doesn't have an external battery, number one, but number two, it does not suffer the same overheating issues that all the newer GoPros seem to suffer when you're trying to power them with an external battery. Also, you can get them on the cheap on Amazon, eBay, Facebook Marketplace, whatever. A lot of people are unloading these Sessions that have been sitting in their closet, and they are great all day filming cameras.
So this setup couldn't be any easier. I use a GoPro Session. This is the original Session. You can use the updated Session. I think it's a Session 5, just the same. A monopod, just a simple camera monopod, an external 10,000 mAh or milliampere hour, I think that stands for, battery pack that you'd recharge a phone or anything with, a night eyes gear tie, and of course a charger cable. And then I've got a external frame for the GoPro that goes on top of the monopod. So the way these Sessions are designed, they have a side door with access to the micro USB charging port. All you do is leave that door open while it's into the frame and attach the micro USB from your battery pack directly to the micro USB port in the Session. Now, of course, that doesn't make that waterproof or water resistant. What I like to do is take a silicone earplug that you can get at Walgreens for $3 for a giant box, and kind of form that around the connection there if you're going to be out in any kind of light, rain, or mist. But if it's going to be raining hard and you're still trying to record, you really can't use this setup, but you can just disconnect it until the rain subsides. So let's go over how I use the monopod in the pre-installed rod holders in both of my Old Town kayaks. So what I did, I just took some pipe insulation and duct taped it around the bottom of the monopod, extended this thing out to the proper height that I wanted it. And that's one of the nice things about the monopod is I can unlatch this and make it longer if I want to get a little better overhead shot. But I just, if I take that monopod with that insulation, make it a tight fit, and just cram it right down in the rod holder, and that, you can see me pulling on that, that will not come out unless I really tug on it. There's a little water down in there. Unless I really tug on it. So you're not going to knock it out by accident or snag it with a pole and pull it out. But it's still easy if you give it some force to get out and transport it between boats or change sides, whatever you want to do with it. Once you've got that in there, you can see up top, I've got the night eyes gear tie securing my battery to the monopod. That does not go anywhere. That's rubber coated, so it sticks. You could zip tie that or run a longer cable down here and set the battery pack down here somewhere if you wanted to. But this works good for me. Wrap the micro USB around the monopod and straight into the side of the Session. So I load that thing with a 256 gig micro SD card. That thing will record all day, no issues. I can press record at the beginning of an 8-hour tournament. Never think about it again for the rest of the day. Same setup would work on a chest mount, but the questions I had were for the over-the-shoulder mount. Now, I know the Session is an older model GoPro, but you can, that's even better. You can get them on eBay, Facebook Marketplace, even on Amazon, whatever, for $100 a lot of times or even less. And then the rest of that stuff is minimal cost. So you can get you an all-day setup to record for $150 or less, very, very easy. And that'll do it. So there you go, guys. That's my easy all-day over-the-shoulder GoPro setup. If you do something different or you have a channel where you have shown a similar type of rig, put your name down in the comments so we can go check those videos out too. Thanks, y'all.